even though he's still doing it. And I forgave him.
I got it. You see it? It fell, cuz. Listen, I had to get it. It was right there. I got it. We ain't got to get physical. I got it. No, the fly was on your head, cuz.
He smacked the shit.
It was a fly on your head.
Wonder why they call me a loke and I'm always in the field. Cause I'm never gon' change. Even when I get my first meal, probably sign my first deal. Nigga, never gon' change. Wonder why they call me a loke and I'm always in the field. Cause I'm never gon' change. Even when I get my first meal, probably sign my first deal. Nigga, never gon' change. Tell them niggas batter up, come and play ball. Ever since I fell back, niggas acting hard. Niggas touched around 100 in the last year. Niggas touch more money than the cashier. I call it how I see it, nigga, never gon' change. And I love spend the money, plus I love the game bang. And I like nice stacks, got these diamonds on my neck. And I fuck bad bitches, so these hoes no respect. In the field playing bullets, nigga, volume 2. Yeah. Homie needed help, I threw an alley-oop. Bought a Cuban and a rope in the same day. All money in, what the chain say? S-I-X-O, disrespect the body, yo. Bet you hear that gun blow, Westside Rolando. And now they call me Rocky from the S-Gang. Full-time banger, fuck the shit change. I never change. Call me a loke, then I'm always in the field. Cause I never gon' change. Even when I get my first deal, probably sell my first deal, nigga. Never gon' change. Tell the why they call me a loke, then I'm always in the field. Cause I never gon' change. Even when I get my first meal, probably sell my first deal, nigga. OT, never gon' change.
Big money, little talk, big shit, shit. Day in the life of a rich crib. Hit a lick, even though I got a due time. Crack niggas out on the blue line. Used to hit Rosa Park, everything new. Cause all the bad bitches want the king
too.
You're now tuned into me. $1 million worth of game powered by Barstool Sports. That was Pac-Man. Never going change. Feature. Listen, man. Pac-Man. Never going change. Feature, my man. OT Genesis, man. West Coast, baby. All love over there, man.
All love, man. I go by the name of Gilly the King.
I'm Wallow 267.
Don't call me white girl.
Tony the Closer.
I like that Pac-Man record.
Yeah, Pac-Man.
And by the way, the reason Rich why I got Crip. This on, because you can go to Barstool Sports.
Everything we got right on, now. You go to Barstool Sports.
You look suspicious.
You want $1 million worth of game, huh? Yeah,
you look like somebody that'd be in jail trying to tackle somebody in New York.
A nigga
coming
that
from
the check cash in place.
Tone definitely like a nigga trying to tackle you, bro.
No, not that type of tackle. Tone, dude. I'm talking about you. Hey,
let's get into our first sponsor.
You're right into it.
This episode of $1 million worth of game is sponsored by CBDMD. CBDMD is committed to providing high quality THC free CBD oil products. And whether you're trying to race in the Olympics or you're just trying to stay up on top of your game, CBDMD is where it's at. Trust me, they give you the best CBD products in the game. And whatever you want, tinctures, you want pet products, you want bath bombs, you want whatever you want, CBDMD. Got it for you. Y'all know me. I'm a weed connoisseur. I'm a CBD connoisseur, and I only mess with CBDMD. So, if you're trying to get you some high quality THC free CBD, make sure you go to CBDMD.com. And CBDMD is offering our listeners, $1 million worth of game, 25% off your purchase. With the promo code Dollaz, D-O-L-L-A-Z, at checkout. Once again, at CBD.com, promo code Dollaz for 25% off your order of premium CBD products.
Listen, man, it's also brought to you by Simply Safe. Listen, if you want your house to be protected, listen, $15 a month, listen, what type of, that's the best security. Listen, man, right now, if you go to SimplySafe.com/game, you get a free, I'm talking about a free HD camera, man, for all our listeners, man. That's for our listeners, man. Anybody that's a listener, you go there, you use /SimplySafe/game, $15 a month, man. You get a free HD camera. Listen, one thing about SimplySafe is award-winning. U.S. News and World Reports named it the best overall
number
home
one
security in 2020. this number year. One. Listen, man, number one, man. Right now, go to simplysafe.com/game and get locked in. Get the security put around you right now.
Hey, listen. This episode is brought to you by New Amsterdam Vodka. New Amsterdam Vodka was born from an uncompromising passion. Great vodka. I'm talking about. Shout out to NAQ, the New Amsterdam Queen, Tootie.
Tootie.
She loves New Amsterdam Vodka. She makes her little cocktails with them. The commitment for excellence enabled New Amsterdam to produce a vodka of superb taste. 80 proof vodka from the finest quality grains from America's heartland. It's distilled 5 times, filtered 3 times for a smooth, unparalleled finish. You could drink it straight up. You could drink it on the rocks. You could drink it with juice, with soda. You can make a New Amsterdam mule. But New Amsterdam vodka is the official vodka for Barstool Sports. Pick some up at any local liquor convenience store, wherever, you know, where they sell liquor at. You can get New Amsterdam vodka there. Or you could just go to Barstool Sports.
You got a fly on your hand.
I didn't see anything.
I thought you were trained by Karate Earl and all
that's
that.
That's because Mona ain't white, but that, ass good.
That was slow as shit.
No, there is a fly here.
That was slow as shit.
Mona ain't white, by ass good.
Now I smell like shit.
No, I'm just playing.
He's a hater.
Hey, listen. Let's get in $1 million worth of game, right? So they say that, you know, they say marriages, right? Babies, you know, threesomes. You know, all these things that people be trying to do in their marriages, they say that none of that shit don't save the marriage.
Well, what do then?
Like, that's my question. So in my opinion, for the people that stay together, what keeps them together?
Communication and fucking.
You been married before?
No.
How you talking to?
First of all, those who can't do, teach. Everybody knows that. People that give the best advice, their lives are usually in shambles. So yes, communication is the key. You're welcome. You can let him tell you because he's divorced.
Yeah, divorced.
Exactly.
What happened to him?
Actually been there, done that though. Like, what that pussy hit for? Because I'm trying to figure out what you got going on.
Where's the sexual harassment bar stools? What are we doing with that? we at work.
We can say whatever the fuck we want to say over here.
I don't work for Barstool.
Like, yeah. You don't need this nigga here, boy.
None of us do.
Rallo, stand up for me.
I am. I'm just saying, like, I don't know where y'all. I don't know what y'all.
I don't know what type of shit y'all got going on.
I was answering a question.
First of all, y'all be on each other's lives and all that. I don't know. When they ain't got nothing to do with us, so leave us out of it. You feel what I'm saying?
She never hang with cousins. You see?
Listen, what we ask you is, you know, none of these things can save the marriage. What can save the marriage? That's what we ask.
You a woman.
I think communication, though, seriously. I really think that's
polygamy. Polygamy.
All right, explain what happened with you, Tone. How the marriage, how long it went in?
Well, one of the things, like, when you get married, man, it's like the women want you more. Like, I think that's one of the things that's overlooked is people think it's the men going out and seeking other women. But it's actually the women seeking the married man. Like, for me, for example.
So you telling me if a broke-ass nigga just got married, yeah, more women going to want the broke-ass nigga?
I think women like
I think a woman likes the idea
of, commitment. For one, somebody that has already shown that another woman has expressed interest in and would even marry him. Like, I think women are almost so competitive with other women that they see that as a competition. If it's somebody that's willing to, definitely if they got their stuff together, you know what I mean? If the person has their shit together, I don't know, like, broke might be different, but when somebody looks at a person that seems like they shit together and they married, yeah, the woman want them more. When I got married, I was like in a position in my life where things were going well and it made, like, I got hit on by everybody. Every woman was like, you know, they were more interested and they knew I was married.
Fucking so you got you bagged more you attracted more women married than single.
Yeah, that's how.
That's
like,
deep.
Like it was crazy. I lasted probably like 1 year, like being faithful.
Like, so
how long was you married?
3 years.
So 2 years, your dick was off the shelf.
After year one, see, and the problem was I was hanging around NFL rich niggas too, so it was like I was doing shit. It was kind of already like you in some situations that's already wild.
Where's the loyalty?
Nah, what you mean? it's just as a man, you get in a position where you definitely, like, this is the problem. Like, a lot of people that don't have money don't understand some of the circumstances that niggas get in once you get money.
What the fuck you trying to say?
Motherfuckers, if you ain't been there, you don't understand it. Like, that, it just is what it is.
So you just saying,
nigga,
so
call
you
me
saying,
bro.
I ain't
call
you, bro.
No, it's not calling
you,
bro.
So you saying you had money, you was married, and then, you know, out of nowhere, chicks was just basically ODS.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, here we go. What's ODS?
Offering dick sucks.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
At a rapid rate.
And that's like no lie, when you got a girl, or definitely a wife, you become that much more, like, they just gonna come straight to the point. They're not even gonna beat around the bush. They're gonna tell you, hey, I wanna suck your dick.
Yeah. Damn. So they just was coming up like, Tony, we wanna tackle your dick.
And hey, listen, and then what you want me to do?
Say no.
Fine motherfuckers coming saying, hey, look, I wanna suck your dick.
So you couldn't resist the fine bitches.
Right,
that's
my question.
You had to throw the glizzy in their mouth.
You couldn't say no.
That's how I got fucked up now. That's one of the things when you
was it at first you were saying no and then you kind of fell,
okay, so
or you
hold
just
on.
Straight was
so
giving dick
on.
Up.
So you were, when you was married after a year, you just had just random bitches you was fucking, or you was in a whole nother relationship? Like, what?
It was the same bitch with the meek shit. So I started fucking with her. She was the first one that kind of brought, I jumped out the ship with. Like, I was like, damn, she was bad as shit. She fine. She in New Orleans. She, you know, she was kind of like Creole looking. You know, she was like a little exotic looking something. So I'm like, if I'm going to cheat, the bitch got to be bad.
Wow.
So this.
How did you get caught?
She told on me.
Damn, she just.
So wait, she wait.
The bitch told on me. So
Wait. Did. You tell her you had a wife?
Absolutely. Kept it a bean. 100%.
And she still wanted to be on your
team? Yeah, she was like, yo, I'm down. She was with
and
everything.
And then she doubled back and ratted you out.
So she seen me take my wife to the Bahamas for her birthday. And I guess her not being able to get that trip put in her feelings. And she sent my wife a whole email with the itineraries, all kind of shit. Like,
did
she,
you stop fucking with her right then and there because she's a rat?
Nah, I kept fucking with her.
Oh,
that pussy was good.
Yeah, because that's crazy.
You stuck your dick in and the pussy reached out and grabbed your balls from the bottom.
God damn.
She knew how to serve a nigga too. So you know if a girl know got
no, she had that pretty face. She look up at you when she's like, sucking a dick. She look a baddie.
I'm talking about the food, like gonna cook.
Okay.
Motherfucking, I mean, even when you fuck,
like,
she
submissive.
Super submissive. Like, hey, look, she gonna wipe your dick off when you finish. I'm like, this is the type of shit I like.
Solid.
You know what I mean?
But you could have asked the wife to wipe.
Hey,
you
what
down.
Man don't like a nigga when you? I mean, the bitch should get up and she.
He went crazy for a dick wipe.
Wipe
my dick off. I was happy.
But, hey. Hey. Really fucked him up.
With a
warm
rag.
She put a little rag in the warm rag.
All the women out there, this is a life lesson.
Listen,
wipe your dick off.
The little things matter.
The little things matter. You better wipe the dick off.
Little things matter. Go get that hot rag. Wipe that dick.
Get ghetto. Put a little lotion on that rag.
Yeah. Why you put lotion on
it? Just put the little scent on it. Wipe them down.
You don't be bullshitting. You know?
Anyway,
wait.
I got something to say.
Why would you put lotion on a rag to wipe a dirty dick off that's been
for the scent? Oils for the scent. It's cute, Gil.
That's
go
some
ahead.
Hood shit.
That's some
you've
deep
been fucking
Delaware.
The same bitch for 20 years. You
that's
forgot.
A,
you
that's
forgot.
A North Philly.
That's some Wilmington Project
over.
Shit right
make
there.
Make a P&J and y'all go back to bed. Y'all been doing this a while. That's,
no,
that's
me,
old school
just,
shit. I got a question.
No, we bro. Don't even wash. We just bust it down and fall asleep.
I hate this motherfucker.
You wake up, your piece stuck to the sheet.
Dick stuck to the sheet.
Dick off my leg.
Piece stuck to the sheet.
Dick like taped to my leg. Yeah, I mean, fuck you wrong with you. 20 years,
poor
we
man.
Fucking fall in a coma.
Too much information. That's not too
what you talking
man.
About?
I got something to say.
And I turn a sprinkler system, a whole bed be wet. I'm laying in the puddle.
Shut up. That's too much. It's too much.
You trying to move your body away from the puddle.
Listen. Seriously, this is where I think niggas fuck up at. Like, to me, it's levels, man. If I'm fucking with you, I'm looking out for you. You know I got a wife. And you violate me like that and tell my wife, I could see somebody really putting his hands on somebody. Like, it's just such a violation. And I feel like it seemed like outside looking in with some of these men, like, y'all cater to the side bitch more than your main bitch. Like, a woman pride be in it. Like, you could cheat on your bitch. That's one thing. But for you to embarrass her, oh, my God. Like, it's just
well,
like.
What's the way the embarrassment come out? I thought the embarrassment come in from the cheat.
The embarrassment come in. Where you take this bitch to the restaurant on the boulevard, you take this bitch to Cherry Hill. Like, you know what I mean? Are you trying to avoid a crowd? Do you take this bitch to the empty restaurant?
Wait.
Or do you take this bitch to the popping club?
Wait, hold on.
Whoa. You understand what I'm saying? Do you give this bitch access to you?
Why everything gotta be some ghetto shit? Who the fuck goes to a restaurant on the bully? Only fucking restaurant up there is IHOP. So it's safe to say a nigga took you to IHOP.
On the tip of my tongue was IHOP. But listen.
Oh,
listen.
So a motherfucker take you to, he'll hold motherfucker bottle with you gotta, is, you take Mona to IHOP and then I pops.
Listen.
Get her some
all seriousness.
Get her some pancakes and then I'm the sheriff.
The difference of taking her to KOP to buy her a bag or order her a bag online. It's like women, for us, that's the ultimate. And we are competitive. And these women do. It's like, it's certain women that tried to fuck you just because they hated her. Like, so when you fall for that bait, that shit hurt. You was a sucker. This bitch was coming regardless. I know women. Nah. Seriously, I know women, and every woman watching this can fucking vouch that hate women enough that they'll fuck every bitch she fuck just out of spite, just out of hate. Like, shit really goes on like that. So it's like, man, nigga, I love
your
you.
Your shit ghetto shit.
You my
I'm
man.
I'm just talking about on some different type
listen,
of shit.
It's, like, it's not ghetto shit. We could all went to the same college. It's a peer thing. It's that some women are that fucking catty, that fucking competitive. Yeah, so as a man, for you to be such a fucking pawn on a bitch beef from fucking, you know, when they was in the same sorority, it's like, damn, you a sucker. You disloyal. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you got to be able to turn some shit down, because it's one thing to cheat, it's another thing to embarrass me.
So, bro. So with a woman, so with a man.
Got me out here looking all
got
crazy.
Me out here
so,
looking
so
crazy.
With a man, in a relationship in a, with a man, you love this woman, where do it go bad at? See, because for me, the only time, only way it could go bad at for me is sex.
Like, as far as y'all cool first and then it.
No. I love you. Ooh, we together. If you with somebody and you decide, oh, we going to get married and we going to do all the things, then you felt some type of way for
right,
this person.
Right,
so where along the line do it get bad at?
I think people change. Man. I think people change, too. I think that, like, sometimes growing and changing, it's hard. It's a process. So it's like you have to really be down with a motherfucker to go through that with a person. You know what I mean? If I went through a phase where I wasn't the happiest or I wasn't the active, but that was just a season for me. You know what I mean? So I feel like for us to really make it, you got to really be down to go through everything with me. And that's what a lot of it is. Niggas pull out, especially men. Y'all weak.
No. Wait, hold the fuck up. No. First of all, let's go. Okay, cool. I got you, bitches. I got you, bitches. Wait. Let's talk the truth.
Let's go.
Okay. Oh, when you meet a woman, she do every motherfucking thing she got to do to book you to fuck in. You hear me? Mm-hmm. Everything she gotta do to book you the fuck in. But then once she feelized in her fucking mind, I got him. Guess what she don't do?
Niggas do the same thing.
Oh, no. Hold on. Can I finish? Can I finish? Guess what she don't do?
Suck dick.
Right. You know who
that's what it is. It's all about dick suck. Right, I told y'all that already.
You know who some of the most miserable niggas on planet Earth is?
Niggas that don't get fucked.
No. Niggas that's in a fucking long ass marriage.
Oh, okay.
They some of the most miserable planet niggas on planet. You know why? Because they dicks always fucking come last. Yeah. Every time he try to
no,
hold the fuck up. I let you fucking talk. All right.
I ain't done that.
All right.
Hey, go ahead. All right.
Every
go ahead.
Time, peace. Every time he peace. Trying to get his dick off
hey,
the
peace.
Shelf.
Come last.
I'm talking to you bitches out there. To all these niggas that's in long fucking marriages, I got you niggas today. I wasn't even gonna get you. I wasn't gonna take up for you niggas. But then she start talking this goofy shit. Every time a nigga wanna get his dick off the show, you know what they scream out? Hold on, wait. I got the kids. Wait.
Oh my God.
I gotta make dinner. Wait.
My peace. Oh,
okay, let's be for real. If you got some A1 pussy, you know how long it'd take
to get
that
out.
Goddamn up out of him? Huh? 8 fucking minutes. You hear me? A arch back and a consistent fucking moan.
It's all in the noise.
You're fucking right. It's all in the noise.
It's in the noise.
All the noise.
It's in the noise.
Fuck is wrong with you? And guess what? He'll be out of there in 60 fucking seconds. Bitch, get the coffee. I'm creaming.
Oh, my
whisper
God.
Whisper in his ear, bitch. It'd be faster.
Fuck is wrong with y'all? So I don't want to hear, oh, you got to cunt. No. Get this dick.
I would agree with that. I would agree.
I bought the groceries. If I don't buy the groceries, nobody in this motherfucker don't eat. So get this fucking dick.
We got him started. It's too late.
No, you fucking right, because it's a his game.
Piece, his piece put on the shelf.
Never on the shelf. You know why?
He talking like it is.
No.
His piece was on the shelf.
No. You know what it is? She tried to put my dick on the shelf, but then she realized that shit ain't gonna work with him. Cause you know what I do?
A scrape.
You put my dick on the shelf. I threw Pornhub on. Prep that motherfucker. Wait till I'm about to unload the clip and stand right over top of your ass in the bed at 2:30 in the morning and drop it on you like bird shit out the sky. Fuck is wrong with you? Wake you right the. You be sleep that hot ass.
I should be more disturbed by this than I am.
No. I'm gonna let you go. She be sleep that motherfucking hot semen, that nice warm semen drop on her motherfucking face out the sky. Yeah, fuck him up. Where I'm gonna put it at? I ain't gonna put it on the blanket.
Oh my god, fuck is you talking about?
No. She sleep with the blanket up the neck up. So I'm dropping right out the sky on her ass. Soon she pop up out of sleep. You thought I was going to waste this motherfucker?
She don't kill you. Why the end of the story, not you dead.
Fuck. You talking about? Let me just tell you something.
It's a lie.
The warmer the semen, shit, you got me fucked up. The warmer the semen, the better it is for your skin. And your skin kind of glowing, so I know a nigga done bird shitted you.
Help.
Fuck is wrong with you?
Anyway.
Is marriage overrated?
Did you call that bird shitted? That whole thing is called bird shitting?
Bird shitted.
Don't try it at home.
Is marriage overrated?
Yes.
Because most of the motherfuckers that got married, they if you got married in 2010, you already divorced.
Damn. I believe in marriage, though. I want to be married.
But you ain't never been married.
That don't mean I don't want to.
I got a question.
A man wears a woman. A woman don't marry a man.
I'm just got a question. How good your vagina is if no nigga ever asked you to marry? No nigga.
I've been engaged three times, bitch.
I'm just like
three rings, nigga. What? Oh, you know. What's up?
MVP.
But they said you got good coochie butt.
I got good coochie.
No, you hear what he said.
I don't know what that
that's when your butt
that gay shit he talking about. That's when your butt.
They was like, because I know a nigga used to fuck with Lil Don Don. He said,
Lil Dirty Don Don.
Yes, I did. I ain't
yes,
no
I, yes, you did, Donnie. You know Lil Donnie.
I don't know no fucking. Did y'all really see it, Donnie together? You really know somebody that fucked me. That's the crazy part.
Delaware Donnie.
Yeah. It ain't no Delaware Donnie.
Delaware Donnie with the Acura, with the
Donnie Delaware,
with the Asian Acura, low to the ground,
the lime green joint. He got the lime green Acura.
You know Delaware Donnie with the motherfucking
lime green Acura,
with the Asian Acura, low to the ground with four motherfucking mufflers on that bitch.
Ain't no Delaware Donnie got this pussy. I'll never tell it. I will never. I will never tell you. Well, Delaware Dottie
put some other on your name. Shout out to Delaware. He said Mona got coochie butt.
And Lily told me not to tell you.
Pop tracks. He fucked Pop.
I did not. Shut the. And Lily told me never to.
Pop 5'4". He climbed up on her too, like a little ass.
Pop is cute though.
Like she like.
Why do I gotta be a hoe? Why don't y'all?
Anybody say you no hoe, Mona?
I say something. I can't. You can't talk about marriage, bitch. Don't nobody love you. Like what the fuck?
I ain't say that, Mona.
I've been engaged three times.
So you saying?
So why you can't get to the finish line though?
So you saying my?
I was scared before. She do know.
Call Lily. She gonna tell us.
She would never do me like that. Call Lily.
Don't say nothing.
Hey, but you know everybody get married.
I can't say nothing.
No, shut the fuck up.
No, fuck that. Nah. We ain't doing it like that.
Lily.
I'm here, Lily.
Who Mona gave that pussy to?
And you
told
me never tell. I'm never telling. Don't tell.
Who did Mona give that pussy to that I know?
I can't tell you.
Right. Right, my motherfucking bitch.
What you say, eight niggas? Oh, all right.
Shut up. She loved me.
She says too many niggas to name.
No, she ain't that pussy but you know
around.
Him, though.
I'm just saying, she said you throw that pussy around.
We from the same area.
All right, let me ask y'all a question. Who would y'all be, right? These are all three black athletes, right?
Athletes.
Yes. Listen, man. They all three black athletes, right? And all of them in their prime, they all great athletes too. They not just regular fucking athletes. They all is some of the goats. And in their prime.
You got my man Sean Kemp in there. You talking about goats.
Fuck out of here, no Sean Kemp. Sean Kemp is the goat of fucking having baby moms. He got like 14 of them motherfuckers. Right? All of them in their prime stood up for racial injustice or, you know, police brutality or they stood up for the home team. I want to know if you had to be one of these athletes as a whole, not just an athlete, which one of them would you be?
Who is he?
Jim Brown, Muhammad Ali.
I'm being Ali.
Or LeBron James.
I'm gonna be LeBron.
I'm being Ali.
Yeah, Ali went out kind of bad though. Ali the greatest. But he went out bad though.
Nah, the way he stood for it, if you're talking about just for the person, man, he hit the whole world.
But who would you be? You would want to be him the way he ended up?
He hit the whole world. Yeah, he touched the world.
I don't know. I'll take LeBron only because LeBron is still getting active now. LeBron is a great example to men, period. Like, I'm not huge on sports, but that doesn't mean I don't know LeBron build a school in his low income area. Like, who the fuck does stuff like that? And that's the thing about it. Like, some of you niggas are LeBron haters to that point. It's like, bro, it don't matter. There's no way you're a black man and you can't give LeBron his props. Come on.
No. Shout out to LeBron. Schools. LeBron did great. Did a lot of great shit.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? But let's be for real. The resources that LeBron James has in 2020, Jim Brown didn't have those resources in 1963.
True. Oh,
no. True. No, he didn't.
Muhammad Ali didn't have those resources. True. Didn't have the opportunities that LeBron James now has. And the reason why LeBron James is afforded those opportunities is because of people like Jim Brown and Muhammad Ali. You feel what I'm saying? Me personally, I think that I probably would be Jim Brown.
Why?
Because, okay, first of all, Jim Brown did that shit his way. Jim Brown was one of the first athletes, black athletes, to be like, I'm standing up for something.
Yeah, he was on some shit.
No, fuck all that. A lot of motherfuckers followed after what Jim Brown and Bill Russell was doing. You feel what I'm saying? So, and for me, Jim Brown got his money and then retired in his prime. Like, no, I'm the best player in the NFL. I'm out. I'm cool. I got mines. I got a bigger purpose. And then, let's be for real, Jim Brown did that shit when it wasn't cool. See, these athletes now, they could kneel. They could do all that. Because the white man said you can. Because the white man approved that shit now. You niggas wasn't doing it when Kaepernick was doing it.
Yeah.
Because you know why? It was the unpopular thing. That wasn't a popular thing.
Cap tripping.
It was cap tripping. And even if you didn't say that, even if you wanted to do it, you wasn't willing to put... It's easy to do it now. Niggas' jobs ain't on the line.
Right.
You can't lose nothing.
Yeah. He lost everything.
It's easy to do it. Damn, no, he ain't lose everything because he still got cashed out. But at the end of the day, he stood for something when it wasn't the popular thing to do. Now it's the popular. Everybody, ooh, hey, that's you, hey, I'm this, ooh.
That's why I said Ali, though.
Right?
Ali went to jail to jail with it.
So No. Ali went to jail because he ain't going to go to fuck to the army.
Yeah, draft doctor.
You feel what I'm saying? They ain't had nothing to do with no motherfucking...
They were trying to go over
there. That wasn't anything to do nothing with no motherfucking...
I mean, but like still, his position was to like, yo, I'm not fighting the white man's war.
Because they don't fight for us.
Okay, that's cool. But what I'm saying is the reason is he ain't going to take that ass to the army and pick that machine gun up. You know what I mean? You hear about how niggas getting shot that they catch on fire over that motherfucker. I'm doing 2 years too. Fuck y'all. Y'all think y'all gonna put me on a motherfucking chopper and drop me right off in the middle of some fucking way I don't know. And I gotta be on there talk about P190. I'm at 645-732 coordinates. All in the background. You gotta concentrate on what coordinates you at. No. I'm gonna fucking jail with Raheem, Lil Jamal, Mike, and them niggas. We gonna eat cheese and talk about the motherfucking Lakers game. You feel what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, they pushed him there
because of what he was standing for in the ring, though. Because at that time, he was a champion already.
Yeah, but he was running with some. I ain't gonna say that. I'm gonna hold my tongue.
With
the nation.
I'm gonna hold my tongue on what I was about to say.
Sometimes you gotta do this shit.
You feel me? But for me, I would pick Jim Brown. That's just me personally. I feel like him and Muhammad Ali meant more to what they did in that time period than what's going on in this time period. You feel what I'm saying? Like, Yes, police brutality. It's all shit going on. But back then, man, niggas was getting hosed down, man. Nigga, they was breaking out the hoses, hosing niggas four blocks down the streets and shit. Imagine a hose pushing you four blocks down the streets, you tumbling all, scraping your biscuit all the fuck up on the concrete and all that shit. So it was different back then. You feel what I'm saying?
I'd be Muhammad Ali, but I wanna ask you, I don't really watch sports like I used to. Because I was, after I messed my ACL up, that really got me out of sports.
Because
I was,
oh my God.
No, I was an athlete myself. But I never, like, I seen, what's the name, one time. I might have seen Kaepernick play one time, but I wasn't, like, when this all transpired, what was his stat? Like, he was still killing shit? Like, what was his whole thing?
He wasn't really killing shit, you know.
But
at the end of the day, he was a big enough recognizable name because he came in. He went right to the playoffs. The next year, okay, he went to the Super Bowl. So it's not too many quarterbacks. I don't give a fuck.
When he had a down year, went down at the same time.
But you know, at the end of the day, it ain't too many motherfucking quarterbacks that ever get drafted that can say they took their team to a Super Bowl. I don't give a fuck how much you like him. If you think he garbage, if you think it ain't too many motherfuckers that can say, "Oh no, I took my
his first
to
couple seasons, he changed the league." Like, you feel what I'm saying? He was balling.
So for me, you know what I mean. Salute to Colin Kaepernick because he did it wasn't a popular thing to do. You know what I mean?
We appreciate you.
Okay, let me ask y'all this, right? What would you do? Right?
No, this ain't I don't. All right, go ahead.
What is it?
This ain't no what would you do? This is a real situation that me and him talk. You
know? No, but we can't put a nigga name out there.
No, we ain't put nobody name out there.
Okay, so say.
That fly on some shit, man.
No, tell him what happened.
Okay, so say you in a relationship with a woman for 10 years, right? You ain't never really felt like you ain't had no reason not to trust your woman. Y'all living good. You got money. When you met her, she was on the down. She lost a nigga. You went to jail. You feel what I'm saying? She got pregnant immediately by you. Immediately. Like, soon as y'all met, her nigga had just went to jail, just got locked up. Y'all start kicking it. She got pregnant immediately by you. Now y'all got two kids. Y'all 10 years in. For some reason, you in the crib, you just like,
This is, jeez.
Let me just. You start going through all that shit.
Randomly.
Just randomly.
It's a hurt piece.
You find a box of prison letters. From the time you met her. Up until now. The whole thing. In the prison letters, it's talking about, I love you, I miss you, I can't wait to see you again. I'm gonna bring the baby up there to see you.
The baby?
It's her baby father.
What you mean is her baby father?
Let me
finish explaining.
Two kids, one of them is the other one. Right. Okay.
So, as you read these letters, you realize all the lies that's being told. All these times she was going up to the jail over these years, she told you her brother was locked up. She going to see her baby father.
It wasn't a brother, it was a lover.
She got, the oldest child is not yours. When she met you,
she was already
they know, y'all know.
She was
pregnant.
Already a couple weeks, a month pregnant.
Wow.
Right?
Yeah.
Now you read these letters, you seeing all this shit, you find all this shit out. What you doing?
You gotta kill the bitch. Fuck it. There's no way.
Nah, you can't.
Murder,
you can't,
suicide. Whole house.
Nah, you can't. We can't even play with that though. Like, you know what I mean? Like, cause at the end of the day, like, When we laugh and joke about that, that starts getting implanted in niggas' heads that they think that when somebody fuck you over, that you're supposed
you
to
go crazy
and kill them.
No,
because
no.
That was my logic. That was my logic. I used to just go, like, it was so much of what I seen and heard that you move like that. The best thing I tell a nigga is, hey, get away. Remove as fast yourself. As you fucking can.
But think about this.
I got one question. Is this he getting out? Is this dude ever getting out?
Yes, he coming home in 3 years.
Listen. Oh my God. But
this old twist though, the whole thing. He don't care. He know what time it is.
Yeah,
The dude, he had all this time that this is his kid and he ain't got no kid.
He gotta get away as fast as he can.
Like he thinking this is his kid. You lying, you writing letters to this boy. But my whole thing, why was you stupid enough to keep the letters in the house?
Yeah, that was wild.
That's how it be. There's no respect.
But them letters, Brian, she just read them. You know jail letters.
If you go off on her, guess who gonna get in trouble? Not her. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Get the fuck out of there.
If he go and fuck her up, because that's what his reaction, most men would be like, yo, I'd be ready to kill you. That's not even my child. You've been raising the kid for 10 fucking years. You find out it's a nigga that you saying is your brother in jail. Like, most people are going to be ready to kill you.
Calm down, just a little bit.
It ain't because you can just see how you know that can fuck with a lot of young niggas though.
Don't play like fuck that
up. Yeah, because it's so many people.
I apologize, everybody.
When I was going through my whole joint, being in an abusive treatment program, you hear so many people that normalize the fact that when somebody disrespects you,
you get physical
mm-hmm. with them. Mm-hmm. So it's so many people that go to jail just based off the reality of like, damn. You know, somebody done did some shit that played me, and now I'm going upside. Because
that's the pattern from the hood. Right. Yep. They do that.
I think the hardest part about it would be in the child not being yours. I just can't imagine. That's the hardest part.
Yeah.
I just can't imagine.
That's his first child. You thinking that's your first child, bro?
Your family.
I can't imagine what a man who finds out. Mom. You know, because as a father, man, when you first see your kids, man, it's like, damn, that's me. Like, it's like they walk and you're like, damn, look at my little man, damn, look at my baby, look at him. You know, then for your kids to be
all them years old,
8, 9, 10, 12, 17, 4, 2.5, 5 months, and you find out, like, no,
that's out of pocket.
It's hurtful on so many different. It's hurtful number one because the kid not yours. Then it's hurtful because you feel like you low key look like a dickhead because you was doing all this shit. Mm. Then it's hurtful because you feel embarrassed. Like now you gotta everybody see. Damn man, where your son at, man? Oh yeah, about that.
Why ain't no consequences for women for shit like this?
About
and
that.
And honestly, I think it should be.
The little nigga ain't mine, man.
Yo, how's there no consequences for that?
At this point, it should be something where you could take her at least to like simple small claims court and get a check. Like, there's no way that if you proven like, you took care of a child that you shouldn't have to pay it
so
back.
So you mean to tell me this bitch told me that this little nigga was mine? 12 years go by, little nigga ain't mine. Take the bitch to simple plank.
Small claims court.
This bitch paid me $26 a month.
I feel like also, especially, on some real shit. What if you spent, no, seriously, listen, all jokes aside, if I didn't say it all the way correct, look, fuck you. What I'm saying is you should have to pay support back. Like niggas pay child support. I've seen niggas pay real child support for 16 years. I just feel like it should be a law at this point that you have to pay it back.
Okay, so what if a nigga been you a nigga make 600, you done bust him down for child support.
Oh my God.
You done took motherfucking little being 50 out of age fucking check this nigga get. And then he find out 12 years later the little nigga ain't his. He been on child support.
He go crazy.
Damn, like that's crazy. That's just a game we don't play. That happened to somebody close to my family and it fucked them up for life. They found out who their real father was at like 14. It really fucked them up. Like it really, like it bothered, made them not be able to trust people. I don't know why women play those games because I feel like
because there ain't no consequences to it.
No, there is a consequence.
What's the consequence? Like,
the consequence is when your child has a health issue and she think he can get his kidney from his father and he can't because that's not his fucking father. You know what I'm saying? You can't get the blood transfusion. You can't get shit.
And that's the consequence. That conversation. You know what's a real consequence though? That conversation that mom got to have with that child.
Yeah, that's a consequence.
That's a vicious.
Now, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. Them bitches don't care. Them bitches do not care. Let me tell you something. If they cared, they would have never did that like that. So they don't care. Don't think they. That's they wild. You got a lot of motherfuckers that say, oh, he ain't your fucking father. The life goes on.
Think about how many niggas in jail for some shit that they done found out like that, but there's no consequence to a female that does something fucked up like that.
And nigga ain't getting out.
There's no consequence. She living her life like everything all good. This nigga done went crazy because he found out she done fucking lied to him about who his child was or some shit like that. That's fucked up.
Yeah, that like there's no way you could get around that, Mona.
What the fuck did y'all hear me say that it was okay to do that? What is wrong with y'all? I just said my goddamn family member is still very fucked up because she found out her father was her father at 14. It really fucked up.
Damn. Is she still fucked up?
Yes, and she's 50. Okay, she's still fucked up.
I need you to do something. What's the, who is that?
It's a family member.
What's her name?
I'm not.
No, I mean, is it my grandma, aunt, sister, cousin? What?
It's something up there. Like
okay,
that.
So this is what I need you to do. Next time you talk to her,
Listen to Gil.
I'm gonna punch you in the face.
No, I'm just asking.
Yeah, kind of.
Y'all hitting the black of my eyes, sir. Yeah, I mean, and you passing it, which was cherry flavor wood tip.
I like regular plastic tip.
Regular plastic tip, and you like DJ. You know what I'm gonna need you to do, Aunt Shelley? What, bitch? Let it go. Right. Okay, bitch. Your dad wasn't there, bitch. You're 50. Okay, that happened when you was 14, bitch. Let it go.
That should be fucking.
Okay, you know what you need to do,
Aunt Shelley.
Grow the fuck up, Aunt Shelley.
Oh my God.
All right, bitch. You okay? You're 50 with kids now. You're not a kid now. You're 50 with kids now. Bitch, your dad been dead for 12 years. Let it go.
He's really dead, too.
He wasn't shit.
He was a genius.
All the niggas that ain't shit like that, they all die like 50. Your dad been
this nigga
dead.
Crazy.
Your dad been dead now for some years.
Nah, that's a dirty game to play, bro.
Let it fuck up.
Dirty game to play.
All right, let it go.
What about the girls that don't know? They're just confused.
Confused about what?
Who the dad is.
Don't y'all know where y'all are playing?
Let it go.
Don't say y'all, because I ain't never been confused.
I ain't seen it.
Let me tell you something.
To me, it's impossible, but I've heard people say it. But to me, it's impossible just because, in my opinion, you know when you're pregnant. You can kind of feel the difference when you're pregnant.
No, you're getting sprayed by four or five niggas at the same time.
No, I'm saying when you know when you're pregnant, then, not sprayed.
That's when the semen demons come
up. Like a month or two after
demons
when
ain't
you're
no
pregnant.
Joke.
That's what I'm talking about. When
you have semen demons.
You are a semen demon.
I'm asking, have you ever had semen demons?
And I'm telling you to get the fuck out of here.
All right, cool. Let's get $1 million worth of
demon time, demon time, demon time.
Mona's new single.
You demon time. Back demon. Up. Like, you no, really
I'm,
let me down.
No,
like
I'm not saying it. I'm saying no, a song. Somebody had a song called Demon Time, Demon Time, Demon Time. I killed the pussy is still. That was the song I had. I killed the pussy is still alive. Demon Time, Demon. That was the name of the dude's song. It was called Demon Time.
Stop lying, Wally.
No, I seen it on Freddie Gibbs.
He said, I killed the pussy that's still alive.
I mean, Freddie Gibbs had that story. He was like, Demon Time, Demon Time, Demon Time. I killed the pussy that's still alive. I was like, yo,
Freddie
dude,
Gibbs
tripping.
He got the best story on
he
Instagram.
Got the, shout out to Freddie Gibbs. Shout out to Freddie Gibbs. Instagram story, man.
Hey,
shit.
Baby.
That shit is he's funny crazy. As a bitch, man. Yeah, let's get into $1 million worth of game. Gilly, I'm 22. I just found out my boyfriend, who's 32, been cheating on me since we was together. 6 months ago.
What's she doing?
He won't leave me alone. He keeps saying I'm a horrible person for not giving him a second chance, even though he's still doing it. And I forgave him.
I got it. You see it? It fell. Cause listen, I had to get it. It was right there. I got it. We ain't got to get physical. I got it. No, the fly was on your head, cuz.
He smacked the shit out of
it. It was a fly on your head. Finish it, yo, man.
He smacked the shit out of
it. Listen, we ain't got to do it. Come on, man.
There's one thing about it.
Cuz, it was on your head. It was right there. I had to get it, cuz. I was. Listen, we ain't got to fight. We ain't got to fight.
Come on, let that nigga disrespect.
Bro, you just finger fucked my scalp, bro.
Listen.
No, man, it's cool. It's cool.
No, no, the fuck.
I'm trying to get you ready.
You just finger fucked my scalp, bro.
No. I did not.
Shit out your
I got the fly. It's dead. It fell right down. It's dead, bro. Chill. Man, we ain't got to get physical, man. Peace, man.
Hey, let me tell you something.
He can talk himself out of anything.
Look, if you ever finger fuck my scalp ever again in your life.
Why you got to make it so kinky?
I didn't
he smacked the shit out you. He ain't finger fucked you. He smacked
I felt
this
shit roll.
His finger went in your ear a little bit.
I felt this shit roll like.
His finger went in your ear a little bit.
I don't give a fuck what's on my
shit. Should have gave that nigga Wet Willy.
Hey, but the fly. Hey, but why the fly just fly?
Hey, listen. I don't give a fuck what's on my scalp, dog.
He missed like shit.
The fly really was on his head.
Yeah, the fly flew on the nigga on head. He missed like.
You was a nut. You gonna let the nigga smack you?
No, listen, cut.
Shut the fuck up, Mo. I'm gonna activate that knife work on him.
Yeah, pull your knife out. Don't keep letting this nigga touch on you.
He'll be in jail.
He missed the shit.
No, don't take it to jail. We can take it to jail. We get him some jail shit. It get different.
It get dark. All right,
watch. I'm going to stick a knife in your fucking back like a steak and roof, Chris, bitch.
Don't touch me with a knife. I'm just saying, don't do that.
Yeah, don't threaten me because that's not a joke. Hug it out, y'all. You want to hug it out? Wallo, hug it out with him.
Why take advantage of the situation?
Don't be body checking me, pussy.
Hit him first, Wallo.
Fuck is you talking about? I'm in the middle of fucking giving out $1 million.
I'm just making sure you are right. I'm making sure your energy right, man.
Fuck is you talking about, man?
I ain't mean to do that,
right, bro. I'm gonna get you.
I'm making sure you're in the seat, right? I'm gonna get you, bitch.
You ain't got to worry about that.
You ain't gotta keep talking to me like that, though.
I'm gonna get you.
Go ahead, read the gentleman.
Gilly, I'm 22. I just found out my boyfriend, who's 32, been cheating on me since we've been together 6 months. He won't leave me alone, and he keeps saying I'm a horrible. I can't believe this nigga slap me in my
On national podcast TV.
Let it go, man.
Smack the shit out of you, like.
Alright, you keep playing.
Let it go. Let it go, man.
Fucking playing.
You gotta get that.
Let it go. Who rainbow ass phone is that? Rainbow.
He keeps saying I'm a horrible. No, get the fuck out of there. Get off me, man.
Dog, come on, man. Stop playing on
me. Turn it down. Turn the volume down. And turn it off. Turn it off. I think it's gonna do that over and over. I just got it.
Hey, dog, what the fuck is you doing, man? Chill out.
He's scared. You know how you do something to somebody, but then you scared of their reaction. He's scared of this nigga a little bit.
I tap him the fuck out right now. I ain't scared of him.
Beat him up.
I don't want to.
Dog, we in the middle of recording a podcast. Talk about it. Be
about it. Go ahead, because you keep bringing it back up.
Because he keep hearing that ring, like ring from when you smack the shit out of him 5 seconds ago.
She put sauce on it.
Remember when you smacked the shit out of him?
Take the sauce. See.
It ain't nothing, but he had smacked you a couple minutes ago.
She was a bullshit.
See what you was like, ugh. Yeah, because your head low as shit.
Smack that crooked ass eyelash straight.
See?
No, you didn't.
He ain't gonna do shit. He ain't gonna do
if
shit.
If you go my eyelash restraint, you could have said it wasn't.
No, Mo,
the right one is. The right one is.
You gotta go to my eyelash company, Mo.
A little crooked as shit. All right, you be all right. Play as fuck up, too. He keeps saying I'm a horrible person for not giving him a second chance, even though he's still doing it and I forgave him. How do I get him to leave me alone? He shows up everywhere. Leave him alone. He's contacting my family.
I think in 30, he older than her, he got about 10 years.
Right. Okay, first of all, let me just tell you women out there this, right? Stop hitting us with the, stop going in my DM, right? Talk about you got this horrible nigga that you don't want to be with no more, but you can't get a nigga to leave you alone.
It's hard to put a man out. It's hard to put a black man out your fucking house.
No, the fuck is not.
Okay, here we
go. What the fuck you mean?
What happened to you?
No.
You want to know?
You know how you call, know how you put a nigga out when you a woman?
No.
You call the fucking police.
Oh, that's what I'm saying. No, that's the only way, and some women don't want to do that.
What do you mean? When the police get there, you don't get the nigga locked up? No, I just want him out of the house.
I just want him removed. That's true.
I don't want him here no more. You don't send a nigga to jail.
But the
nigga got to get the fuck out.
But Gilly, right
now.
You
got guns on them, warrants, all kind of shit.
They don't come near. They don't do none of that. I need a nigga to get the fuck out.
Gilly.
Man, I don't want to hear that.
See?
These women really don't want a nigga out the house.
You can't tell him nothing.
The fuck out of here. Because they love the dick. They love the DMP, the dick and problems. The fuck out of here.
I've had to get creative. They
be in a relationship with a nigga. They act like they can't get away from the nigga. No, you can't get away from the dick.
That's not it.
And why do certain people...
Okay, why when bitches get raggedy dick, they get away from them niggas fast?
Listen, I'm not
why they get away from the raggedy D's fast as a bitch?
I am not saying that you not right. I'm just saying that.
Fuck out of here. So you telling me.
It's hard to put a nigga out. Sometimes you got to call your brothers and your cousins and shit, and you don't want to call the police. Right now, calling the police to get a person removed from your property could cost a nigga his life right now.
No. First of all.
There's a lot going on.
That's the motherfucking excuses. Let me tell you something. If you're a woman, you not in the game. You're a civilian.
Okay.
How the fuck is you gonna say, oh, I can't get out of a relationship because a nigga don't wanna leave my
That's
house?
That's not what we saying. What I'm saying is that it's hard to put a nigga out.
Why it's hard? He come to.
Listen, the reason why it's hard to put a nigga out because these niggas.
The fuck out of here.
They ain't got no way to go.
Let me tell you something. If two wanted me to fuck out the house, she'll call the motherfucking people.
Come get me.
I don't want him to get locked up, but he got a kid. I just want him out the house.
He gonna be like, Lo, come get me.
Fuck you talking about. And me being a nigga that I am, soon she picked that motherfucking phone up and remotely called 911. I hear somebody on the other end of that fucking phone.
You out. Low, come get me.
Oh, I'm fucking up. She'll need y'all. I'm leaving. Yeah. I'm going. Okay, but you for real. You want me to fuck out for real. Okay, I'm out. I don't want to hear no, oh, you can't. That ain't snitching. Bitch, you a civilian. Yeah. You ain't getting a nigga locked up. You getting a nigga put the fuck out your house. And then, okay, can I get that key back, officer? Just, I got my key, officer. Okay, bam, I got my key. I'm good.
My mother fuck was a civilian. My mother never, she just didn't. I mean, some people just don't deal
because
with
your mother sold cocaine. She wasn't going to tell never, you that.
Well, my mother was a nurse for 25 years. My mom ain't a drug dealer. Yo, where you no, my mom a nurse. My mom is a real square. I don't know what
I'm thinking like,
about.
Damn, your mom was selling rocks?
My mother has never sold drugs, bro. Like, my mom is straight. She's still a nurse right now. She's still working. Man. Shout out to Wanda. She was a motherfucker.
Mama Wanda was leasing.
My mom gonna fuck him up.
She was leasing the whole fucking Wilmington.
My mom like Jack. My mom's from North Philly and she's a nurse.
Right. So, yeah. Okay, let me just
listen, Gilly. Hear me out. It is hard. Listen, as a woman. No, wait. Wait. God damn it. Wait.
Before you step, remember that. Your mama is a refurbished. No, no, no. She's a refurbished nurse. You know how motherfuckers had their first life and then they retire and get their second life together.
Tread lightly, motherfucker.
No, your mom refurbished nurse.
This is what
nurse.
I'm saying. My mother's a nurse. A
after she moved at work. Okay, when did your mom become a nurse? She didn't
my
become a nurse.
My mother been a nurse since 1990.
Right, okay.
She was 20. Like, shut up.
Your mom was 20 and 90?
Yeah.
What's your mama name?
Like, my mother's gorgeous. This is when my mother have hair in her bag. My mother's gorgeous.
I might have picked your mama back. My mother was popping back.
My mother is gorgeous, and you did not fuck my mom for sure.
How you know?
Because you
did. Did you ever ask her? Call her real quick. Let me ask her.
Okay, let me ask my mother.
Let me ask mom.
My mother's going to cuss you the fuck out.
I'm just going to say, mom.
No, don't ask her no fucking shit like that.
Why? We the thank same you. Age. Fuck you, Jumbo. Did I fake you back in the day?
Yeah, I ain't.
We the same.
Don't do it.
Don't call.
Don't do it.
Is she in a relationship?
Oh, my mother? Yeah. No, she's single.
Call your mom. Let me just find out. No. I'm big the back in the day.
No. Marlo said no. Listen. No, seriously.
Not ass nigga.
Speaking for the women because
I know.
It's not
like I'm. You looking at it like, that's her mom. That's my peer. That I could find weird. Out if I baked her back in the
you
day.
You did not bake my mother.
About how you not baked all the bitches back in the day. I'm just keeping it real. All
you ain't hit
them.
My mom. Yeah.
Your mom was gorgeous.
My mom was gorgeous. She long was on the hair, menu. Green eyes, all
oh,
that.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
Yeah, my mom's gorgeous.
Wanda with the green eyes.
Wanda with he the lying. Green eyes.
The little fat ass sitting up like
fat
the kids
ass.
On Christmas Eve.
Yes, fat
he
ass.
Lying. Yeah, oh, yeah. My, oh, oh, yeah. That was. Oh.
Gil
you
bullshit.
Talking wonderful Wanda.
Oh my
stop
God.
Fucking playing. No, listen, because you know, Gilly has taught me everything from how to suck a dick to how to do a lot of things for a man.
Gilly
but I have to be the one to tell out. You to speak for it us sometimes. And the truth is, as a woman, it is hard to put a black man out. Like, don't get it fucked up. What he's saying is that we might be fucking with a piece of shit and then we excuse a lot of shit because we addicted to the dick or we really want the dick. But for real, when you done, it's hard to put a man out, especially
no,
if you have children with
let
them.
Me tell you something.
They will stretch out. I had to get creative with motherfuckers damn. To get them out. Like,
let me,
seriously.
Let me tell you something.
Like, yo, we got to get the house.
If you was
house.
Done, would it be hard for you to leave?
No, I'm walking out.
The men don't leave. Y'all are saying that you would yell over and say, oh, she don't need no help. I'm ready to go because you hear the cops. Do you know most niggas, when the cops get the door, they'll start pulling out mail? Well, I get mail here illegally. I should what? Be able to stay here.
Oh,
because
shit.
I get, 'cause if you get mail in the state of Pennsylvania, you can stay for 30 days. You have to go through a certain eviction process to put them out.
Of this shit.
Oh, I ain't go through a lot, but
nigga.
I did have a problem putting a man out. And especially,
she tried
I ain't
to put
got
a
no
nigga out, he said.
And most of the time, what's the situation?
Nigga, hey, nigga, jail letters there. I get mail here.
Men men nigga, always.
Nigga don't get no bills. This man writing from upstate. Yeah, I get letters here.
I've heard get y'all here on Million Dollars Every Game say to guys, to younger guys, what do you tell them? You tell them to get your own apartment. I'll tell you niggas that right now. That's where a lot of you young guys fuck up. Your first spot be with a bitch. And every time yep. she get mad, she say, get the fuck out. You understand what I'm saying? So
and it's in lot, her name.
And it's in her name, even though you pay every
so
fucking
so to all you
youngins,
your first spot be with a bitch.
It's a bad move.
When it should be with the clip.
The
then clip. Y'all run them clip. Over
the
and
squad.
Slap them all
yeah.
with the dicks.
Yeah. Oh my God, this nigga. No, seriously though. A lot of men, I know men that have reached 30, 40, they might have owned a home, whatever, but they never had a home on their own. It's already been a women. A lot of men are codependent on women
oh, yeah,
in
I
that way.
I live with two right now. Fuck is you talking about? I always live with two.
Right.
Let's get into stories from the cell.
Motherfucker. This nigga.
Stories from the cell.
Like,
now, a lot of people see me on the streets and they always say, wow, low man, you got to let Mona tell stories from the cell. At the beginning, she told one, two. But I said, all right, I'm going to give her a shot, man. Mm. Let her tell one of these
stories from the cell.
Stories.
Light skin edition.
Stories from her cell.
Well, I think. Okay.
One day when my titties was getting sucked.
All right, this is a good one, y'all. This is a great one. So when I was in FDC, shout out to all the bitches down FDC, 3 North, 3 South, okay, third floor, women run to jail.
Go gang, gang.
Men can't move around, okay. I used to, I had a bold buddy named Maurice. Shout out to Maurice. Now, a bold buddy is somebody
Maurice.
That you.
My name was Maurice? That was a dude name? Or...
I had a bold buddy. Let me explain what a bold buddy is. And some of these prisons.
Maurice was a nigga.
And some of these prisons is male and female.
Gotta go to most.
So what people do is they start a little system through the toilets where you can fish and talk to each other from floor to floor.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So a bowl buddy is the person that you talk to, hello, through the toilet. And y'all end up
we
going
talk
together.
The vents.
And they send you.
Y'all was going together?
Shit. Yeah, I went with Maurice on Third North. So me and Maurice were in love. We were planning on
talking through the motherfucking toilet bowl.
Talking through the toilet, but y'all the thing about me is I was a different type of bitch because
would you
every
know
time I got to talk on the phone on the toilet, right? I always had the young buck clean it out for me first. Okay,
so you respected
she was I respected the bowl rules. Okay, so number one, you had to clear the bowl water with your knee, right, in the pillow, the rubber pillows with the rubber pillowcase. We always used trash bags. Everything was very sanitary. And our phones were long.
Mona, you got to understand.
I could lay on the bed and talk, hello, through my pipe to my bowl buddy, Maurice.
Now, would you...
You seem so interested.
How long was y'all together?
Maurice never fucked me. We don't meet. How
y'all
have
bowl sex before?
We had a little bowl sex. We have.
What you was in that saying?
I was saying a lot of kinky shit, but
like
me and Maurice, shut up and let me tell the story. Me and Maurice that's were in love, and he told me his name master. Was Maurice, yo, and he told me he was from Southwest, and our line was towards. Yeah, I seen him because I was the picture girl, and I worked in laundry. So I wore my tight pants, and I went upstairs to see him, and I slipped him a picture. Yes, I did. Anyway,
Damn,
I thought me and Maurice was going to be together, and unfortunately... when
she
I was
in the toilet.
When I was in class with the bitch from D.C.
One of y'all wasn't shit.
When I was in class with the... A lot of people talk in the toilet. Beanie Siegel used to talk on the toilet, too. I talked to you, too, a couple nights, Siegel. Don't front on me.
Oh, damn. You, was
yeah,
he,
it was like
he
it was FDC at the same time, see?
So
we was at FDC at the
jail?
Same time. I
no.
was at FDC, nigga. Square-ass nigga never been to jail.
No, ain't no. Oh, don't sorry. Say that. Ain't nothing wrong with
playing.
Not being
no,
in jail.
Listen.
He did
that's
10 days in jail.
I know he been in jail.
But ain't
in jail
nothing
hold. Listen wait, to wait, what I'm saying. Wait, it's wait, my story from the cell. It's my story from the cell.
I was locked up at CFCF. Tootie God. Was locked up at Rockview.
Jesus Christ.
She wasn't up to Rockview.
No,
she
what,
wasn't
what's the,
Rockview.
What's
the state prison?
No, no.
For
what,
men.
What's the
girl
jail,
one?
What's the jail? No, the jail right across the street from CFCF.
It's some initials.
Pick. It's PIC.
No, it ain't no fucking PIC.
RCM.
RCF.
RCF. Right.
Can I get back
oh,
to
no,
my
no,
story?
No. I just want to know this. So if Tootie was bowling over in RCF, she could talk to me over at CFCF?
No, that's not how I go. Let me tell you, look, it's most of the time it's when the jail
building.
Is in a Lord. Tower, right? So when the towers are connected.
So the jail got men and women in the same jail?
Yeah, but different floors.
Different floors.
The federal building. Go ahead.
So you, do you have it all the way?
I didn't know he was in the feds.
Yeah,
for that
little
bullshit
money.
Ass punk ass trafficking fucking black and miles. I didn't know they fucking lock you up with the feds for that
I've
shit.
I've been disrespecting this episode. Right,
cool.
I feel beat
you,
down.
Cool,
I, you
I
know,
got
it's
you.
Rough.
I got you,
it's rough doing this with these niggas.
I didn't know
Wallow
you went to
the
feds
the
for trafficking
and
B&M.
I hold it down.
I always hold you down.
But today, you was just, you know what I mean? This nigga, no, I don't no, fucking
Mona,
know no
I'm
more.
I'm sorry. I did not know you went to jail for trafficking B&Ms.
But I'm going to say this, Mona.
I talked in the toilet.
Mona, hold on. I had to stop you. Cause I had to correct
this story
you on one thing.
Been so good,
you
y'all.
Said Gilly was a square because he never went to jail.
It was a joke.
Nothing is cool about going to jail out
guys,
there.
Guys, it's not.
Please.
I'm sorry.
Don't
it's,
take
it's,
that.
That's terrible.
Boy, say what you got to say. You had a boyfriend. You was in love. You was ready to get married.
Why you said you was thinking about going back?
My fucking ass.
What?
You're selling.
Today.
What? What you
said?
It's been a rough one.
You was thinking about going back.
I never. What was we at? I told you
that. Super offended. Wait, listen,
no, you niggas showed up.
No, no.
Listen, so I was in class and this fat, stinking, wide bitch named Nicole from DC, fuck you still, bitch,
damn.
Approached me, asked me, was I fucking with somebody named Ronald? And I said, no, bitch. I go with Maurice from Southwest. But he was talking to both of us on two different lines. Low down, dirty motherfucker.
He was a bowl player.
And I got right on that bowl. And I yelled and yelled. So he picked up. And I said, nigga, give me my picture back. It took me weeks to get my goddamn picture back.
So he was the winner of the Super Bowl.
No, that nigga was cheating on me with a fat bitch from D.C.
But you was a little.
Did you ever get?
You said you was a little.
You ever give him some commissary?
Fatter. I've always been curvaceous.
You ever give him some commissary?
No, I don't pay
you said
no
you
man.
You was a heavy Chevy though.
I've always been curvaceous.
Did Maurice get commissary to you?
No, Maurice ain't really give me nothing. Curvaceous? But I used to have a boy boy named Smooth. They used to look out. Tobacco, lighters, weed.
What's curvaceous?
Curvaceous is a smaller waist with wider hips. Boom, boom. So even I was big, I was like this. Boom, boom, boom. You know what I mean? Boom, boom, boom.
So what's the difference between a boom, boom and a boom, boom, boom?
Have you ever seen a bitch shaped like an ice cream cone?
I seen a bitch shaped like a bag of ice banged up against a tree.
You ever seen a bitch shaped like the nigga off of the bitch Despicable Me?
I seen a bitch shaped like a Hoover back, a vacuum bag.
You ever see a bitch shaped like a vending machine?
I seen a bitch shaped like a goddamn NFL primetime motherfucking... personally signed Deion Sanders football.
You ever see a bitch shaped like a lunch lady named Bernice?
I know. Only Bernice I know is the Bernice Burgos.
No, we ain't talking about that. We talking about, you ever see a bitch shaped like Tony?
Would you the fuck tackler? Bernice? Oh, yeah. I seen a couple bitches shaped like the tackler.
Yeah. The worst shape is the bitches with no hips with the big back. You big like this and you go in like that. It's like ice cream cone melting. It's very sad. Oh, it's depressing. See, the shape is what get them. You know what I mean? That, you know, 36. 24, 36. It's been a rough episode for me. This nigga got on my nerves the whole time.
Well, don't worry about it. We'll make it up.
Yeah, but that's my story for the sale. Shout out to Maurice. And I want to also shout out Maurice because he ended up having a shootout with the cops on 15th Street.
What?
That was him.
How the fuck would you want to shout out Maurice?
That was the same guy because he was all over the news. I'm like, hey, that's my bowl buddy. I've always wanted to tell somebody that. And he was an informant.
It gets deeper. Shout out Maurice for shooting out the cops.
On 15th Street. Do you remember that? That big standoff a couple years ago on Erie Avenue? You was home. Remember that big standoff? That was my bowl buddy. He's right back in prison, that motherfucker. Thank God I didn't stay. Thank God I was smart enough to leave.
I don't know what the fuck she on this joint talking about.
It's been a wild episode. He be so confused this
Hey, listen, man. Make sure y'all tune in Rona Proof each and every Sunday, 3 o'clock, right? You gotta stop changing the motherfucking time. Cause the motherfuckers be in my DM. Man, Tone said he gonna be on fucking 3 o'clock. Now he on fucking 5:30.
I had some shit to do.
Hey, 3 p.m. It's free. If it's free, you just show the fuck up and just get the text message. You're going to come on. You ain't got to pay no money. So you just get on when you get on.
Get it.
And also make sure y'all stop by the closer.com.
Oh, yeah. Go to closersdata.com.
Closersdata.com.
That's going to get you the 7-day free trial to the best data. You get over 10,000 records a month that you get access to using that system. That's what we use to find all our leads. You definitely want to go get that.
Yes.
Absolutely. So. We appreciate y'all for tuning in each and every week, making us number one music podcast in the country. Go get your merch, barstoolsports.com. Get your merch, get your merch, get your merch. Look.
Get your merch.
You don't need to have no mask on. Now you just, yeah. You just get your $1 million worth of game.
Goddamn.
You just get your $1 million worth of game. Turtleneck. Goddamn. Turtleneck's back in style. So I'm in a Wally.
Oh, yeah. Turtleneck. What? With some slacks?
Under his jerseys back in the day.
You look a little bit like a turtle.
He used to rock a turtleneck under a Bo Jackson jersey back in the day. I was like,
I was ahead of the game.
Did you ever wear the little hoop?
No, nigga.
You give me a little hoop vibes.
But the nigga had a
Michael Jordan wore a fucking hoop.
He had a black and silver.
A freak.
Bo Jackson jersey with a burgundy turtleneck under it for no reason. Like,
why would you do that?
I don't know. He was just on,
some. I was on some. That's what Bo and them wore. I wore what the champions wore.
Was your ear pierced?
No.
Did y'all ever had a shag in the back?
No, he got his lower back pierced, but he did that in jail. That's some whole different shit.
What? You got lower back tootie on there.
We'll talk about that in the next episode. Appreciate y'all for tuning in each and every week. I go by the name of Gilly the King.
I'm Wallow 267.
I'm Don't Call Me White Girl.
But call a white girl.
Tony the Closer.
It's just like that.
Right!